Welcome back to another episode of 10 Degrees Warmer. My name is Rob.
And I'm David.
And we today are going to talk about Sydney, Australia. I probably should preface this by saying we loved it.
Loved it.
We had a great time. And we're just going to talk about six things that we did while we were there that you might be interested in.
We're David and Rob, and we are taking what we are hoping will be a four-year sabbatical to travel the world. We've lived in and traveled to over 75 countries and territories over the past 30 years, and we are here to share our unconventional life of long-term travel to give you an example of what is possible.
All right, so the first thing we wanted to talk about, obviously, is Circular Quay, which is the main, like, tourist area in Sydney. It's where the Opera House and the Bridge and everything kind of is. So 100% you're going to go here when you come to Sydney, and it is definitely worth taking the time to look around. So, I mean, first, let's just talk about the Opera House, because...
It is gorgeous.
It's amazing.
Like, yeah. You see pictures of it all the time because it is so iconic. But once you get up close to it and see it from every angle, you really start to appreciate how spectacular it is. And you see what it really looks like when you're up close. It's covered with tiles that are in patterns, and it's just gorgeous. I didn't even know that it was like that.
Yeah, definitely worth just doing the full 360 and walking all the way around it. There is a tour which we didn't do. I did it like 20 years ago. It's really cool to kind of see the inside and get a little bit more of the history of the controversy from the architect. But anymore, it's just so iconic. It's beautiful.
Yeah, and from there, you can see the bridge and the harbor perfectly. And when you walk away from this Opera House, you hit the quay where all the buskers are and all the restaurants are, and there's museums and millions of people, and it's exciting to be a part of the energy there.
It's a lot of people. There's a bunch of ferries that come in there, like just local ferries and some of the longer distance and little sightseeing boat tours you can take. There's even a cruise ship that docked there one of the days that we were there. So it definitely is a busy, lively area if you want to have a coffee or... just kind of walk through and people watch, definitely worth it.
Bring your camera.
Yes. And then if you continue around, all the way around, now the place we walked through was actually where the cruise ship let off, but the ship wasn't there that day. So I don't know how different it is if there's a ship actually in port, but when they're not there, it's all open. And we just walked up and you can get underneath the Harbor Bridge, which is some cool views there to see. There's some cannons, there's beautiful views. We saw like four or five different couples taking wedding pictures there with the Opera House in the background. So it's just sort of there's a little park down there where there are a whole bunch of rainbow lorikeets that we watched for a while. But definitely worth walking all the way around if you've got the time to do it. There's also in the ground, this is just kind of silly, but I loved it. They've got these metal plaques that have quotes from historical figures and authors talking about Sydney and Australia. And they're just kind of cool to read, you know, what people thought of that city, you know, 50 years ago, 100 years ago. Just some inspirational quotes. I thought it was really nice.
That's cool.
But you're definitely going to go and you have a great time.
Number two, right across from the Opera House are the rocks, and it's a historic area where a lot of old buildings are. There's a museum over there, an art museum, I think a museum about the rocks area, and it's also where the bridge, the Sydney Harbour Bridge, begins to go across the harbor. It's a really cool little area, lots of great shops and restaurants. They had a Christmas market happening at the time, so we walked around and looked at that. We also climbed up to the very top of the rocks, and they have an observatory up there. and a nice park that surrounds it, and it was really pretty and great views of the bridge from up there too. So it's worth walking.
And it's kind of fun up there because you see like the typical side of the bridge from Circular Quay and the Opera House, but when you go up there, you're on the other side of it, and it's just a different view that you don't usually get to see.
Yeah, it's a nice angle of it. Yeah. And then also from up there is where you can get onto the bridge and walk out across if you want. And of course we did, because we walk everywhere. If there are steps, we take them. There's two other options to get up on the bridge and have views. One is the bridge walk, and yeah, do you know anything more about that?
You can actually walk up onto the top of the bridge. It's like $200 or $300 Australian dollars, but still like way more than we care to pay.
Not what we're going to do.
And then there's the pylons that you can go up. And 20 years ago when I was there, you could just walk up them for free. Now they charge. It was like $17. So much cheaper option if you just want to get a little bit higher view.
But I don't think necessary at all. Totally not. You still get great views just from being on the deck of the bridge.
Yeah, we just walked across, and it's just beautiful seeing that whole harbor underneath you with all the boats and ferries and everything moving around. It's really beautiful.
Yeah. So that's another great area you can explore.
Definitely worth just walking around too, because the buildings are super cute and there's lots of little nooks and crannies. We really like that area. So number three is another pretty obvious one, but it is Bondi Beach. There are a lot of beaches in Sydney. Manly Beach and some of the other ones along the coast, but Bondi is probably the most iconic and famous and definitely worth taking a look out there. What we did is we kind of came down and got to the coast a little ways. I don't remember the name of the beach, but to the south of Bondi. And then there's a hike you can take that just connects all of the beaches. And we just walked along that for a while.
And it was gorgeous.
Beautiful. We had great weather. I mean, it was a beautiful day. But just kind of walking along all the rocks and the different little beaches, and some were surfing and some had swimming, and like, it's just beautiful. And then you get to actual Bondi Beach, which is huge, and just like a lovely beach.
Yeah, and I don't know, it seemed like it would be crowded because it was summer. Mm-hmm. But there weren't that many people there, and it didn't feel crowded at all.
We probably were there on a weekday. Now I can't remember what day of the week it was. That kind of gets fuzzy sometimes.
Yeah, maybe early.
but one little tip, just in case, there is a big building right in front of it that's got like some shops and stuff in it. But we had come the other way, and so we weren't sure where. We wanted to stop and have lunch, and we were kind of, there's a little bit of grass, but it was all like right in the sun. But on the back side of that building, they've got picnic tables that are kind of covered. And so we were able to find one of those and eat our lunch. There's a whole bunch of them, but definitely worth it.
Sydney has lots of big, beautiful parks, and they are absolutely worth your time to walk around.
We went to several of them.
We went to several of them. So first, and I can't even say best because they're all great, but probably most well-known is the Botanical Gardens. They cover a huge area that runs all the way up to the Opera House. So you can't miss it. And they're gorgeous manicured grounds, lots of individual areas that show different types of plants, lots of birds, lots of people. It was really a beautiful park.
Yeah, some restaurants scattered around, coffee shops and stuff. Just beautiful.
Yeah.
And you can see a lot of the iconic birds there too. They've got the ibis and the cockatoos. Definitely worth looking around.
Yeah. The next park I'll talk about is Centennial Park. Mm-hmm. It's probably one of the less known parks, but it's massive, and it is in the city there. We walked, again, I don't think there's a train that goes very close. I think Bondi Junction is probably the closest, and that's still a little walk, but the park is worth it. It has tons of ponds that are just full of water birds. The park is very active, lots of fun runs and biking events happening there. And I think the highlight for me, probably for you too, was there's a little forest right to the north of the ponds. And in that forest is a bat colony. And it's full of, I think there's two kinds
fruit
of
bats.
Fruit bats that live there. And it's just, it's noisy and they're all bickering with each other and flying around. And it's really quite spectacular to watch them.
Yeah, definitely worth it.
Yeah.
That was unexpected. We didn't know it was going to be there. And we just stumbled on it. And we're like, what's that noise and that smell? Oh,
yeah.
It's fruit bats.
So if for no other reason, go to see the bats. Our last park I'll talk about is the Olympic Park. And it is the park next to where they held the Sydney Olympics in 2000? 2000 Sydney Olympics. And you can still see all of the venues where the sports were held. And right next to it, it's a big park. There's a mangrove swamp that you can walk through. It leads right up to the water. There's the brick pit. And it's where the clay was excavated to make the bricks that created a lot of early Sydney. And now it has been turned into a frog sanctuary because they have found some frogs there that live nowhere else. And there's a big pathway that goes all the way around that. So that's pretty interesting also. Super tip is if you go there, either on the way there or the way home, take the ferry. That way you get a cheap ferry ride. Instead of taking one of the expensive cruises, you can just hop on the public ferry and it gets you there and back and you get to see a lot of the harbor. And that was really nice.
Yeah. This is another little tip is that one of the big things they sell in Sydney are these harbor cruises. So you can go around and see the harbor. And generally, my experience on them is they tend to be very long and boring. Like, it's beautiful at first. You're just like, this is awesome. And then I would fall asleep because you're just sitting there for a long time. So kill two birds with one stone. Get out on the harbor and see it. But be doing it while you're getting some transportation out of it as well. Where the ferry picks up is a little bit outside of the park. It was a little bit of a walk.
A little bit of a walk.
But totally worth it.
Easy. So those are some of the parks of Sydney.
So our next recommendation for things to do in Sydney is the Art Museum of New South Wales. This is a museum we kind of just stumbled across. It's next to the Botanical Gardens, and it is excellent. They've got a lot of exhibits that talk about the indigenous Aboriginal people and the art that they have been producing, as well as some of the art that came from the, you know, European colonizers. What made it really special, though, because museums can kind of be hit or miss sometimes, you know, it depends on your mood and how tired you are and all that kind of stuff. But they offer tours. And definitely, if you ever go to a museum, try to take a docent tour. We have been on so many of them, and it always makes it a better experience.
Always better. And they're almost always free, too, which is great. And the museum is free, if we didn't say that yet.
Yes.
So,
yeah, so totally free, easy to do. Just pay attention to when they're offering the tours. Our docent was a volunteer, wasn't even a employee or anything, but she knew her stuff. And she gave us some really interesting insight and backstory to the pieces that she showed us. Really, really interesting, and we just really liked it.
And our last suggestion for when you're in Sydney is to go out to the Blue Mountains.
Is to leave Sydney.
Is to leave Sydney, yeah, why not?
Good morning. So today we're taking a trip to the Blue Mountains from Sydney. So we are taking the train. We are here, it's about 6 o'clock in the morning. And we are getting on the train to Lithgow?
Katoomba.
Katoomba is our stop where we're going, but Lithgow is the end of the line. So we just came down and found our train over here on our intercity services. And we're about a half hour early because we do things early and we're just waiting for the train now. But it tells us, the map over here told us what train to get on, what platform to get on. And we're going to get on the train and go out to the Blue Mountains. Hopefully it's going to be a good day.
And it's from the Grand Concourse.
Yes. Okay. One thing to note is there is a light rail right outside. And you just want to make sure we're not looking for the light rail. You definitely want to get on the train. We talked to someone last night who actually paid for the light rail that they didn't actually need and got charged like 10 bucks for nothing. So just make sure we want to get on the train to Katoomba. So that's where we're going. We'll show you more along the way.
Okay, quick tip. We've been told that when you get on the train to Katoomba, sit on the left side of the train. If the seats are the wrong way, they do this. So you can face front or back. So we have switched our seats. Hopefully we're on the left side of the train when we leave the station.
And then from Katoomba, you could either take a bus or walk out to the point where the trails begin. What is the main feature is called the Three Sisters, mm-hmm. and it's called Echo Point is what you're looking for. The train cost us about $9 each round trip, but that depends on time of day, if it's commuter time or off peak hours.
Might be different on weekends.
Might be different.
Yeah.
At the Blue Mountains, it's a cute little town, first of all, Katoomba. We walked mm-hmm. through it, we walked around a little bit. But the views up from above are spectacular, and if you are up for a hike and a bit of a challenge.
We did a long hike.
It is lush and gorgeous and rocky and twists and turns. It is a bit of a challenge at times. But so worth it. And then you can walk at the bottom of the canyon where it's lush and you hear all kinds of birds. I think the highlight bird for us was the lyrebird. They are gorgeous.
It's kind of like a peacock, but
they're,
Australian
They're kind of
style.
Not gorgeous. They're a plain brown bird, but they have this super long tail with all kinds of curls and ruffles, and they're pretty amazing.
And they make a lot of noise.
And then, of course, you have to hike back up.
Hello, if we look a bit exhausted, we completely are.
We just went on a hike. Well, we're not done with it yet, but we climbed way down there. It was 900 steps down, and we just finished the 900 steps up. I will say coming up is much more sweaty, but the going down was actually harder, I think. We just finished the climb up, catching our breath, and then we have to hike back to where we started from. But it's been a very fun, good day. Just a little cloudy and misty, and so far we have not seen the Three Sisters, which is why people come here, because it was all shrouded in fog. But hopefully by the time we get back, it will have lifted a little bit. It's kind of raining.
A little bit, drizzle.
We'll see.
There at Echo Point, there is a visitor center, and you can ask the rangers in there for suggestions on where to go or where to hike. That's what we did. And they led us on a good hike.
Because when we got there, it was really foggy. Like, the Three Sisters is the thing everybody goes to see, and we couldn't
they
even see it at all.
Absolutely
completely
invisible.
Covered. So we went and talked to the ranger, and he's like, do this hike. By the time you get back, maybe the fog will be gone by then.
And it was.
And it was. So then we got to come back and then see, like, the real views. But, I mean, besides the lyrebird, when you look out over the valley, it's just, you can see all the white cockatoos just flying all over the place and hear them screaming, and they're everywhere.
It's really cool.
It was really cool, yeah.
So I think that's what we have for our suggestions in Sydney. Yeah. And all of those were free other than transportation.
So there's tons of free
stuff
to do.
Stuff there.
It's an easy city. And like he was saying, like, you can just walk around, and there was this like big lunch festival that they had. And there was like a disco area with disco singers. And a country one. And a carnival themed one. It's just like a really fun city that's got great energy. I don't know. I just loved everything about it. Definitely recommend that you check it out when you go to Australia.
Yeah, and if you have any suggestions, we would love to hear about those too in the comments.
Oh, because I'm sure we missed stuff. So yeah, please put them down in the comments.
We were only there a week.
So. Yeah, or if you have any questions for us, also leave that and we will get back to you. But yeah, from here we are moving on to some more cities in Australia. So those will be coming up shortly. We'll see you then.
Two kinds of fruit bats.